There we go. Probably it was one of the mods that we disabled. Would that be the legendary Iron Man Insane plus 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 four-man run? I don't know, Skywalker. To be honest, I don't know. I think we cannot go on insane difficulty with only four men. That's not going to work out. So, welcome everyone to Operation Cursed Glove. We are about to raid this supply raid. We are nearing the end game. We have nearly finished all of the plasma weapon upgrades. We're so close, so damn close to finishing the whole, to go to the end game. And that's why we need to be also so careful. We don't want to lose guys. Good. We know that there are no... that there are no high ground options here. Nice. And that's the advantage of a small map, right? You already know that there, you are going to face multiple packs. There's just no way around it. Solid copy. And of course, that was a sarcastic comment. That's really one of the disadvantages of these small maps. Good, let's see what's up. I think we should be fine with the one pack here, as long as the other pack doesn't add. Ghost Coder asks, how do you have more than four soldier classes? There are mods that allow you to install additional classes, and there are actually a lot of classes. And we have tested some of them, or many, to say the to be more precise. And we have hand selected three of them to be appropriate and applicable for our games here. The Scout, which is an alternative version to the Ranger. We have, which is focusing on guns mainly and has more of a mobility aspect. We have the Rocketeer, which is an alternative to the Grenadier, but with more dense and impactful rockets. And we do have the Gunner, my personal favorite class, who is a badass infantry type of enemy class. It's not really an enemy if it's your own guy. Good, so how do we want to start with these guys? I suppose we can go for a nice little double tap here. Let's start with the Advent Mech. Yep, there is certainly some more power behind the shots now. Good fucking job. Finally, with blue screen rounds and with blue screen rounds, we are finally capable of more or less one-shotting them. I'm on it. Hostile terminated. Good. Let's continue. And maybe we first of all take the ones that are in that are not having blue screen rounds. Yeah, good job. Nice little hit. Double tap really pays out. That's good. All right. Okay, so before you're going all, before you're going completely mad on this guy, how about we start getting rid of his cover, or just instantly killing him? That's of course also an option. Good. So the reason why I wanted to stay with him is and keep his shots. He can still go for the tower with his blue screen rounds, and he basically also one shot the tower. That's good. Yeah, the first run of the game, I would suggest that you do it plain vanilla without any mods. Just to get to know the enemy types, how everything works, like the research trees, how the game plays out, and so on and so forth. It's really a good experience to understand how everything works. If you're starting to mod it right away, there you might find yourself in a position where you're not comfortable with knowing what's going on. The first time when I played it, and you can see that in season one, I did a lot of stupid mistakes, basically by not knowing what's going on. Yeah, and if you're new on XCOM, then that's perfectly fine. No one is going to force you to do mods in the first instance. Effectively, I would really suggest go with a plain vanilla game. There's the second tower. We're going to go with a tower with our usual strategy, which is use the squad side, just use the Phantom Ranger for reconnaissance purpose. And use our squad side guys to finish off the tower. The tower can't hit shit because it actually can't see anything. Oh, that was, by the way, the wrong squad side colleague. We wanted to have one of the gunners. But it doesn't matter because we are not in a time pressured situation here. Affirmative. Covering now. On overwatch. Here I come. I suspect that we do have anywhere between 5 and 6 packs on that map. First one we have cleared already, so it is a good moment in time to now start clearing the rest. Moving on target location. Good. Let's use the positioning to our advantage, like. Where's the line where they can see us? They could see us from here. Basically from here. That's the first moment where they can see us. Which effectively means... I'm on it. We can just move up a little bit. Specifically with our ranged DPS. Good, we wanted to have Bosketeer here as the second frontliner. Tired of waiting around. On the move. All right. So, mostly reloading, steadying the weapons. And with steadied weapons, we should do okay. The turret needs to get some legs. Yeah. Well, I'm okay with it being static. We have forgotten to steady his weapons, so we're just redoing the exercise again. They are not moving, hence we can just steady our weapons. We want to increase the hit chances from 88% to 100%. Don't want to take any chances here. Yeah, that's the 100% that we're talking about. Okay. Double tap time. Here we go. First shot. Let's pull that pack. Hello there. 13 points of damage. That's 5 mutants and an Archon. Holy moly. And as always, they have taken a solid cover. Let's spread out, so we're not giving them any motivation to use their grenades. Keep in mind, all of the mutants, and I mean all of them, do have a grenade. It's not as easy as it might look. Come on. That should remove all of the cover. And it even kills one of them. Yeah, of course. It was the only one that is carrying loot. Of course. Good, so second mutant down. Because fuck you, mutants. Hostile terminated. Third mutant down. Well, the Overwatch is too good to pass by, so might as well go on Overwatch here. And to make sure that everyone's like safe, we're giving Bransky here an 8 protocol, and then we're just Overwatching that. Bransky will get an extra shot because he now has threat assessment, and Sniper gets an Overwatch as well. Velius effectively should remain as the scout. That's the threat assessment I was talking about. Here we go. Wow, a little bit of an overkill, I'm not going to lie. Yeah, and the Overwatch ability doesn't mean shit if you're not hitting. Of course. Menace 1-5, watch those supply crates. If you destroy them, there won't be anything left for us to recover once the area is secure. Thanks for the tip, Captain Obvious. Thanks for the tip. I'm a little bit pissed that they have missed like both of the like all of the Overwatch shots nearly. And of course, the only thing that he wanted to do is get close up and personal, and throw that grenade. He sacrificed his life, his family, his belongings just to throw that one grenade. He could have taken a shot, and he could have just stayed into cover and saved us a lot of trouble, but no. Not him. He wanted to be the guy who throws a grenade. And that's how the AI always works. That's the reason why I don't want to give them any option to even throw grenades. And of course, they are targeting the back line, the guys that are having the lowest HP, and the ones that could be one-shotted. Good. Let's not do anything stupid here. Instead, we're reloading, overwatching. And yeah, surprise. There we go. One more pack. That looks like a mutant demolisher to me. Yep, that pretty much looks like a mutant demolisher to me. Good, time to remove the cover again. The explosion of the car deals some extra damage, so we have two casualties up front. Wait a second, wait a second. Yep, well, let's go here. That's one hit. And the face-off should kill both of them. Yep. So, quick work. They didn't even stand a chance. We're going to use our scout to further advance and double check if we're going to find more packs.
I'm on it. Scanning.
Affirmative, covering now.
I guess we should reload and just overwatch for now. Mainly because some of the guys already are low on ammunition. Good. All right, let's go on. We pretty much know that there is gonna be some sort of a group over here. We have seen that there is some heavy mech pack that was running around the streets there.
On the move. I'm on it.
On your order. So let us slowly but surely move up. Interesting. I think they're going to come closer now.
Here I come.
So let's just solidify our position, which effectively means we're leaving our back line a little bit further to the back. And let's see if they're moving into us. Elite Viper and a couple of baddies.
Moving to position.
Good, let's move up.
On the move. Tired of waiting around.
Let's move up and see how we can engage upon them most cleverly. I would say positioning the sniper like a little bit further to the back here. Problem is this here is a vision blockage, so you want to have a good aiming angle, which ultimately means you need to position the sniper like here. But this tree also is, yeah, rather suboptimal. The other option is getting closer and shooting via this direction here, which I think is gonna be useful for these guys. But there is really no substantial cover other than like this here. This here could be an option, and last but not least, let's spread a little bit, and we're positioning him over here. Should still be a decent aiming angle. Good, let's steady the weapons.
Finally. Moving to Overwatch.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Affirmative. Covering now.
If we're moving her like here, no, that's already going to trigger. Good, next turn we're about to start. All right, here we go. Well, that's number one. Wow, really? That's a lot of advent guys. Need to get some better vision, I suppose. Here we go. Berensky. Oh, the explosion from the car effectively just terminated all of them. Good, let's move up here because I feel we can be a little bit more cocky. And with this face off, we should at least kill three of them. Yep. There we go. There's still one of the guys behind, and we also see that there is a stun lancer group just around the corner. So, number one, let's give Belder here the aid protocol because he's the only one not in full cover. And with that, he also gets threat assessment. And let's wait for the last guy, and maybe the other group has heard us as well. Yeah, Belder just decides the other group needs to be pulled. And there's the group with the advanced mech that I was originally talking about. Oh, come on, guys. If there is the big fat robot, this is the moment in time when you don't want to miss it. Okay, one thing is blatantly obvious. Our gunner here, Ghost Host, is in a pretty bad position. We could kind of remove most of the cover, but it would cost us some additional supplies because we're destroying the whole train. But I guess that's worth it overall. So Berensky does what Berensky does best and removes the cover. Belder keeps on massacring them. Finally, with blue screen rounds and enough weapon upgrades, we can finally kill the advanced mechs. That's so satisfying. Good, let's move her over here. Sniper, Lancer. Lancer's got a lance, baby, so let's suppress him. Let's see what's happening. The sniper just got himself killed because he was moving out of full cover. Pretty stupid idea, by the way. And now the Lancer. Is he gonna take the shot? Yeah, but barely survives. Of course, spots out our guy. Fuck you, Lancer. Not only for spotting out our scout, but for dodging all of the shots again. Yeah, of course he takes the lance before he's being eliminated. Like, he spots him out. And Velio's like, okay, bro, go ahead, please, lance. And then he shoots him. What kind of teamwork is that, Velio's? I mean, what the fuck? You let your friend be lanced and then you kill the guy? Maybe with the explanation, oh, he was at least standing still. Easier to hit. Yeah, that was overall an okay mission. I would say that was decent. I think we kind of killed 30-ish. I don't know. Average amount of enemies. My personal highlight is that we finally found a way how to deal with the heavy mechs. That was the Lancer's moment to shine. It would be rude to spoil that. Yeah, that's one way to look at it, I guess. Yeah. This is one way to look at it. Good, Barack Obama. What is going on? I think we're going to give you Guardian. He's a Major as well. 11 missions. 30 kills. Pretty decent. Supplies. Illarium Crystals. Alien Alloys. Shit ton of corpses and one Illarium core. And we got a second promotion, which we missed. Bosketeer. Oh, nice. Look at that. Ready for anything. When she takes a shot, she's now gonna get her free Overwatch afterwards. So, yeah. And the Overwatch shots, again, can trigger multiple times. So I guess she's gonna be a real infantryist, rifleman, that is. The only point of criticism that I would have is the infantryist here, let's wait and see the other skills, I don't know them yet. But the only point of criticism I would have is the weapons themselves deal less damage than the ones from the gunners. And the gunners are extremely, extraordinarily strong, I feel. They are just adding a whole new dimension to the game because they have so many shots themselves on a regular. So yeah, let's see how she deals with that. Reduced contact costs, okay. We don't need reduced contact costs at the moment. We dealt with this. Let's get the supplies. I'm thinking about if we save enough money. Alarium? No, we don't have enough alarium and we don't have enough alloys, but maybe if we save enough, we can get the sniper upgrade as well. Insanity, stasis shield. No. Return, recruit new staff. Get the fuck away. Don't. Oh.
Welcome, Commander.
Okay. We don't want to be caught out. We certainly don't want to be caught out. So let's just leave South America for now. It seems they have understood that we're there. Good. Good for them. Let's go to the black market. We can't really buy anything. I mean, yeah, probably we'll just need to buy Alarium. It's just like super costly overall. I don't like it. It drains so much intel to buy all of the Alarium just for the upgrades. There we go. Wonderful. That's the second last upgrade for Arnob. And by the way, guys, whilst we are at it, I told you that with the new workshop, we can build PCSs. So let's take a look. We don't even need the advanced ones. I guess we can take the normal ones. Let's see. We would need 80 supplies. Oh, it costs 10 Alarium crystals. Well, that changes everything. If it wouldn't cost Alarium, then I wouldn't have any issue here. But since it costs Alarium, we might wait until we get the superior ones. Because these ones are, in my opinion, not worth like the 10 Alarium crystals. Expanded magazine. Yeah, let's build one because we do have a couple of weapons where like the expanded magazine definitely would make sense.
Commander, that UFO contact has us locked in.
Why is that happening?
Setting course for the West African sector.
Yeah, it's now flying around the world and then it's going to get us. And I can click wherever I want. It doesn't make any sense. It will now come from the left-hand side and then say, "Surprise, motherfuckers, we just flew around the whole world." Yeah, to just shoot you down.